Our top story at this hour. The number of dead in the communal clashes in Uttar Pradesh's Muzaffarnagar district has gone up to 12 and more than 40 people have been injured. 10 army columns, which is over 800 jawans, have been deployed in Muzaffarnagar. Two of these columns are deployed in the adjoining Shamli district. 1,000 policemen and 38 companies of paramilitary forces are also on the ground, ensuring people remain indoors. But there was fresh firing in the morning in the Shahpur police station area. Some people have been injured. Over 30 people have been arrested so far for deaths and clashes. 12 people were killed as members of the two communities clashed in different places in the district yesterday. A local TV journalist was among those killed. Chief Minister Akhilesh Yadav has appealed for calm, and a senior police officer has told NDTV that curfew in the rural areas of Muzaffarnagar district will remain in place for a week.
Night, we attended to a number of calls from the rural area. Fortunately, when we verified, there wasn't any incident. Today, since morning, everything is peaceful. One report has come to control room at Shahpur police station. They are attending to it. More or less, I suppose, after we have roped in army, 8 columns, 5 for rural area, they are patrolling, 3 in city area, they are patrolling. 25 additional companies, paramilitary forces, and out of that, 5 PAC. They have been called in from other local areas, and partly they have come from Delhi. So after that, extensive patrolling is taking place. We have provided paramilitary forces to each police station in the rural area, because the problem is in rural area. City, as you have toured and roamed around, it's almost pretty peaceful, though curfew is there, but there's no incident like that, and we hope that there won't be any. In rural area, we have to be watchful maybe for a week's time, because after the Khap Panchayat, some of the leaders, the kind of utterances and statement which they made was very irresponsible. And we have also instructed them that if anyone who takes law in his own hand will be very severely dealt with, to the extent of if there is any necessity of opening fire anywhere, they will do so. If there is any industry, if you see, the owner is from one community or the laborer from other community. So in those situations, they are interdependent. So any disturbance like this will definitely hamper their business in the long run.
Will the curfew be lifted anytime soon?
Yeah, well, let the normalcy come completely. There's no point.
All right. Thank you for talking to us. So senior officials from the Uttar Pradesh police actually assuring the people over here that normalcy will return soon. At the moment, the situation is calm. But as we mentioned, that senior officials and also several army personnel are camping here at Muzaffarnagar to keep an eye on the events that take place later today and to make sure that nothing goes out of control like what we saw on Saturday evening. With cameraperson Arif Radhu at Muzaffarnagar, Tonima Biswas for NDTV.
स्थिति पूरी तरह नियंत्रण में है, तनावपूर्ण है, ग्रामीण क्षेत्रों में थोड़ी ज्यादा तनावपूर्ण है. फोर्स का डिप्लॉयमेंट कर दिया गया है, आर्मी की रिक्विजिशन कर ली गई है. 8 कॉलम्स ने अभी तक रिपोर्ट किया है, और की व्यवस्था की जा रही है. पूरा एरिया डोमिनेंस कर लिया गया है, इसके साथ पैरामिलिट्री फोर्सेज बुलाई गई है. 35 से ज्यादा हमारे पास पैरामिलिट्री फोर्सेज कंपनी उपलब्ध है, इसके साथ सिविल पुलिस उपलब्ध है. पूरी तरह से पूरे डिस्ट्रिक्ट के सभी थाना क्षेत्रों को और सभी सेंसिटिव एरियाज को कवर कर लिया गया है. किसी भी प्रकार की तनावपूर्ण स्थिति के लिए निपटने के लिए हर प्रकार की व्यवस्था है. अफवाहों की वजह से जो छोटी छोटी घटनाएं संभावित हैं, उन पे ज्यादा नजर रखी जा रही है.
जहां सख्त कार्रवाई की जरूरत है, सख्त कार्रवाई के लिए भी निर्देश हैं. कर्फ्यू भी लगा है, और मेरी अपील होगी वहां के सभी लोगों से कि जहां शांति का माहौल बना रहना चाहिए, शांति का माहौल रहे, अफवाहों पर ज्यादा भरोसा न करें. और मैं समझता हूं कि सरकार पूरी जिम्मेदारी से काम करेगी. जो माहौल को खराब करेंगे, उनके खिलाफ कार्रवाई होगी.
Let's go over to NDTV's Anand Zanane to get a sense of what's happening in the larger picture after the Muzaffarnagar clashes. Anand, even as the death toll from Muzaffarnagar's clashes yesterday continue to rise, the situation continues to be very, very sensitive on the ground. It is also a very sensitive political situation. Tell us more.
Absolutely, both politically and administratively, it is a challenge for the Akhilesh Yadav government. We are hearing that the BSP leaders, the leader of opposition in Uttar Pradesh Assembly, Swami Prasad Maurya, is going to do a press conference in just a short while from now. So clearly, the opposition will try and corner the government on the issue of law and order and communal violence. Several instances have taken place ever since Akhilesh Yadav became chief minister, and this is perhaps one of the biggest incidents of communal violence in the state. And clearly, there were telling signs that something could happen in Muzaffarnagar for the past 10 days or so. But the warning signs perhaps were not adequately read by the district administration, which is why the situation really spiraled out of control. There were several flashpoints in Muzaffarnagar, which perhaps should have been manned properly. There should have been adequate deployment. Was that deployment there, not there? Those are the questions that are now hounding the government. Also, why did the government really allow a Mahapanchayat to unfold so close to a site where there was communal tension for the past 10 days? Those are the questions that the government will have to give answers to. Right now, Akhilesh Yadav is at his residence and is in meetings with senior police and administrative officers as to how, you know, the government is really trying to ensure that a certain sense of normalcy is restored. But clearly, this is once again reflecting on the lack of administrative skills of the Akhilesh Yadav government, because we've been questioning that, and the opposition also has been questioning that, because clearly a lot of violence and a lot of law and order disruptions have been reported from Uttar Pradesh in the past year and a half that he has been the chief minister. So clearly this is something that the opposition will exploit in the days ahead. Now what we're also hearing is that you know, they are also looking into whether any hate speeches were really made in Kawal, where this Mahapanchayat was called by some political leaders who were also present there. Those are the kind of evidence that the police is also trying to gather right now, and right, which eventually led to all these mobs heading back to the city and clashing with the people of the other community. So how did this situation precipitate itself is, that is something that the Akhilesh Yadav government is also trying to understand at this point in time. But clearly a lot of flak coming Akhilesh Yadav's way for his mishandling of the situation.
Thank you, Anand, for joining us with those details.